Oh, hey there. This is Peter, and welcome to another Take a Break with Valley CAD. In today's video, what we're going to be working through is the freeze bar, and also looking at some hybrid modeling and how different effects of hybrid modeling will add weight and complexity to your model. So, get your favorite cup of coffee like this guy did, or your favorite cup of tea, and let's hop on over to SOLIDWORKS to learn something new about surface modeling and how to lighten the load on your part file. I'll see you over there. Hey there, welcome to SOLIDWORKS. So you see here, I got a pretty cool looking guitar body here, and this was actually a lesson that we taught in our recent surface modeling course. And you know, if you want to learn more about surface modeling, check out our website, give us a call to see when we're going to be offering the surface modeling class again. We had a great turnout in our last class, and this lesson that we talked about was coming in and showing different ways of using hybrid modeling. And hybrid modeling is where you combine solid bodies with surface bodies, and you get some really cool components out of it. And as I push Control Tab here, you'll see that I actually have four different part files here, and they all look identical to each other, but they were all using different forms of surface modeling, hybrid modeling. So like, for instance, the very first one here that we have up is called Replace Face. How this actually looks at the beginning is I extruded out this component a total of 2 inches out, and there was a surface body that was being used in here. And by the way, if you have multiple bodies in your part file, if you hover over a component or body and push Tab, that'll hide it. If you want to bring it back into view, you just push Shift Tab, and I'll bring it back into view. So as we look at this first one here, this surface body, it looks nice, like it has cool curvature to it and whatnot. But as we look at this guy here, I want to replace this planar face with this curved one. And so the replace face command will do that for me. And then so from here, I just simply push Tab and that hides it. So that's the first one. And then the other one that we use was called delete. And so with delete, how this works is that we extrude this out X amount of inches. I believe we did 2 inches on this one as well. And then we used a delete face command. And with delete face, that just removes the planar surface, or any surface, I should say, of the model. And it turns it in from a solid body to a surface body. And then from there, we did our next step where we used surface body trimming, and that came up with our final component as well. And then the third option here was called cut with surface. And cut with surface, I use this one quite often when it comes to hybrid modeling. And so how this works is you come up to under the surfaces tab, and you have a command here called cut with surface. You have to have a surface body in order for this to work. All right, so as we come in here, this one's extruded out. You know, this one actually came out 4 inches. It doesn't really matter. It just has to extend beyond the surface body. So I'll make it so we can see this guy. So you want to make it so that your surface body extends all the way around your solid body, and then make your solid body go beyond the surface body. And from there, use that surface body to cut away from it. So that way you come up with this part here. And then the last option here was called up to next. Up to next is an end condition. And so with this end condition, we said go up to surface instead of blind. And so we selected the surface body, that yellow component. That's what we clicked up to. That's what it came up to there. All right. So that's how we came up with four different variations of hybrid modeling. But to let you know, they all had their great, like, you had the same output from every single one of them, but you might be sitting there going, well, hang on a minute. Some of these actually take longer to rebuild or to open. It adds weight to your file. Like, it does. So how can you tell how much weight a file has? If you come up to your Evaluate tab here, and under Evaluate, you'll see a function that says Performance Evaluation. Now keep in mind, I am on SOLIDWORKS 2021 here. If you are on an older version of SOLIDWORKS, like older than 2016, it'll have a different term there. But if you are on 2016 or newer, it's called Performance Evaluation. So as I click on this, it'll tell me that, hey, your file has this X amount of features, solid surface bodies, and my total rebuild time is 5.54 seconds. If I do a Control Q on this again, now it says 1.66. okay? So I decided to do a quick rebuild. So what I wanna do is show how this actually affects your model all the way around. So I'm gonna do a window here, and we're gonna set up so that we're gonna set up as tile vertically. So now we can see all four different components here for me. Okay, so the very first one here is called up to, right? This was the one where I did extrude up to surface. This file takes about 2.13 seconds to rebuild or to open for me. And the feature that's taking the most amount of time on it is actually this knit surface command, okay? And that's what that performance evaluation will tell me. Now, as I come over to my delete body one, I'll do a quick control Q to do another rebuild for me. Notice how long it's taking for my model or my cursor to update there. Come up to performance evaluation, it actually took 3.56 seconds. Okay, and once again, the one that's taking the most amount of time is that surface trim. That's the feature that's actually at the very bottom of my design tree. Then we'll look at body cut. Do a quick control Q again. Control Q is a force rebuild. It goes through and it rebuilds all the features in your design tree. We'll come up to performance evaluation. This one's taking 1.61 seconds to rebuild, so not as bad. And then our last one, which is replace face. So I did a control Q there. Notice that my cursor is definitely spinning on me. Performance evaluation, 2.86 seconds. So as we look at this, you could see that, hey, we all have the same part file here in the end, but which one would be the best route to come up with the fastest model or the lightest model? Now, in some examples, you might have to use the delete face and replace it, or you might have to do the cut with surface body. So in those sort of scenarios, what are you gonna do if it takes forever to rebuild? Well, this is where we come up with the freeze bar. So I'm just gonna make my up to here. Actually, let's do the delete one. That one took the longest amount of time. So I just simply restored it so it took up my entire space here. So as we look at my design tree, you might notice something that's a little different on mine compared to maybe yours if you don't know about this function. It's called the freeze bar. So one thing to note here, the freeze bar lives at the top of your design tree. It's this orange bar up here. And if you don't know this about SOLIDWORKS, when you open up a file or you save it or you do a rebuild, SOLIDWORKS starts at the top of your design tree and it works at each feature underneath it. So when I first open up, it's gonna go to surface revolve. Then after that, it'll look at angled plane, then plane one, then top shape trim, sketch three, and down the line it goes. So because SOLIDWORKS does that, if you have a scenario here where a feature might take longer to rebuild, or if it has rebuild errors, it might have child or dependent features have issues too. So the freeze bar, what this does is it comes from the top down, and everything above the freeze bar gets frozen. Thus, it also lightens your rebuild time, lightens your file. So if I do a control Q again, you know, it is gonna chug a little bit, but let's see here, how long did it take that time to do? Performance evaluation took 3 seconds at time. And the main reason why it's taking forever is due to my surface trim one at the very bottom. We also notice here that top surface knit, you know, this feature here, has also taken up about 35% of my rebuild time. So let's test this out. If I take my freeze bar, let's roll it down right below delete face and I do another control Q. Let's see how long this takes. Not as long. Performance evaluation here. Now my rebuild time is basically cut in half, right? Now we're at 1.69 seconds instead of the original 3 seconds. So the freeze bar can really help speed up your modeling on your files here. I'll do another control Q and we're done. So this freeze bar is only available in part files. And you know, I'm so excited about telling you about it. How the heck do you find it, right? Well, what you need to do is come up to your sprocket here, and under your sprocket, you'll need to come under your system options. And from system options, you'll go to general. And under general, you'll see a checkbox here that says enable freeze bar. I always have this turned on and I recommend everyone to turn this on. If you don't want to use it, it just lives at the top of your design tree. No harm, no foul. It is just gonna live up there. But if you do need to use it, you just simply take it and roll it down, and that will help speed up your rebuild time, open time, save time, and also lightens your assembly. okay? So there's some pretty cool setups with that. So hopefully that helps out with being able to learn about some hybrid modeling with surface modeling. It is a really awesome technique to be able to work through that, but also coming in and utilizing your freeze bar. So once again, my name is Peter Estes. I'm the founder and owner of Valley CAD. I really hope you enjoyed your cup of coffee or tea as you learned something new about SOLIDWORKS. Come back next time as we learn something else as we take a break with Valley CAD. Have a great rest of the day and make sure you learn something new.